Dear students, I am Mahesh Javalkar of Maratha Mandal Polytechnic. So today I am posting my seventh video on DCET questions on the subject digital communication. Okay. Now this video contains questions on transmission media, so guided and unguided media, and in that also we can have coaxial cable, we can have twisted pair cable, UTP, STP, and then we can have optical fibers. Okay, so basics of these things should be clear if you want to attempt any objective type or MCQ type of questions on these topics. So let's start with the first question over here. Question number 121. Dash cable consists of an inner copper core and second conducting outer sheath. Okay, so if you see the structures, twisted pair does not have this, shielded twisted pair also does not have this, coaxial cable can have this because it is having an inner copper core and a second conducting outer sheath. So here the option should be option C, coaxial cable. Okay, then we'll go to the next question. Question number 122. Dash cable can carry signals of higher frequency range than dash cable. Okay. Now, if you're carrying signals of frequency range, means we cannot speak of fiber optics. We have to speak about coaxial and twisted pair. Okay. So, dash cable can carry signals of higher frequency. So, automatically, as compared to twisted pair, coaxial carries higher frequency. So coaxial cable can carry high signals of higher frequency ranges than the twisted pair. So answer should be answer A. So answer A is the right answer over here. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 123. The inner core of an optical fiber is dash in composition. Okay. So the inner core of an optical fiber can be made up of glass or plastic. So here the answer will be direct. It can be made of glass or plastic, the inner core in which the light travels with the principle of total internal reflection. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 124. In an optical fiber, the inner core is dash the cladding. Okay. So the inner core refractive index is more than the refractive index of the cladding. That means the inner core is denser than the cladding. Okay, so the answer should be answer B, denser than. Okay, because the inner core has to be have higher, that is more refractive index as compared to the cladding material, so that light will follow, travel, propagate through the inner core only with the principle of total internal reflection. It will not leak into the cladding. That is why the inner core is denser than the cladding. The refractive index of inner core is more than the refractive index of the cladding material. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 125. Dash cable consists of two insulated copper wires twisted together. So it is there in the answer only. You are having two wires which are twisted. So it is nothing but the twisted pair. So answer A will be the correct one. You are having a twisted pair. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 126. In fiber optics, the signal is dash waves. Okay. Now we know that in fiber optics, the signal is in the form of light which travels. So it is light waves. So here the answer should be B, light waves. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 127. A or an dash. The medium provides a physical conduct from one device to another device. So, if you are having a physical connection from one device to another device, then it is called as guided media. Okay. So, it is answer B, which is called as guided media. So, a guided media provides a physical conduct from one device to another. Clear? Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 128. Transmission media are usually categorized as, okay, So basically, when we studied transmission media, we saw that basically it had two types. One was called as guided, which will be a physical wire type of connection, guided media, and another is wireless connection, that is unguided media. So here the option C will be the correct one, guided or unguided media. Okay. The next question, number 129, dash media transport electromagnetic waves without the use of a physical conductor. Okay, so electromagnetic waves, if you are traveling, if you are making electromagnetic waves to propagate, then you are speaking about unguided media. You are speaking about unguided media. In unguided media, the electromagnetic waves are going to travel. Say, for example, for your mobile phone, whenever you speak in your mobile phone, that speech is converted into electrical. That electrical signal will be modulated with the carrier, and that modulated carrier from the antenna will be converted from electrical to electromagnetic, and then the electromagnetic will go into the space because it is wireless connection to the receiver mobile. And in the receiver mobile, that electromagnetic waves which receive will be converted to electric wave by the receiving antenna. Then the electric wave, which is a modulated carrier, will be demodulated. Information will be extracted from that, and that electrical information will be converted to sound by a transducer, and the person on the receiver can hear what you have sent from here, what you have spoken from here. Okay, so that is how it is a unguided media. So here the answer should be answer B, unguided media. Clear? Then we'll go to question number 130. Dash cables are composed of a glass or plastic inner core surrounded by cladding with a encased in outside jacket. Now this description is of an optical fiber. You are having an inner core which is made up of glass or plastic. Then upon that you are having a cladding that is also made up of glass or plastic. And upon all this arrangement, there is a jacket. There is an insulation jacket, the jacket which will give you strength. Okay. The light travels in the inner core with the principle of total internal reflection. So this description is of fiber optics. So option C will be the correct one. It is fiber optic. Then we'll go to question number 131. Which of the following primarily uses guided media? Okay. The options are radio broadcasting, satellite communication, local telephone system, cellular telephone system. Now, if you see radio broadcasting, it uses unguided media. If you see satellite communication, there is also no wires used, it is unguided media. If you see local telephone system, this is guided media because phone lines are connected from one point to another for the voice or the data to travel. And D is cellular, that is mobile phone system, which is also unguided media, wireless. That means here the option should be option C, local telephone system. Okay. And now we'll see question number 132. When a beam of light travels through media of two different densities, if the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, dash occurs. Okay. The options are refraction, reflection, criticism, and incidence. Okay. So here, the option, what we have studied, okay, refraction is one thing which is below. When the incident angle is below the critical angle, it will pass into the another medium, so it is called as refraction. But if the incident angle is more than critical angle, then in the same medium it will reflect back. It is like total internal reflection. So here the option should be option B, total internal reflection, that is reflection. So if the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, reflection occurs. And this concept is very important when light travels within the core of an optical fiber. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 133. Which of the following is not a guided media? Okay. Now if you see option A, fiber optic cable, it is a physical medium, it is guided media. Option B is coaxial cable. It is a physical medium. It is a guided media. Option C is twisted pair cable. It is a physical cable which is guided media. Option D is open space atmosphere, which is used for wireless communication. So it is not a guided media. So here option D will be the correct one. Atmosphere is not a guided media. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 134. Dash cables carry data signals in the form of light. So it is very obvious. The option A, twisted pair carries in the form of electric current. Option B, coaxial also carries in the form of electric. Option C, fiber optic is one which carries data signals in the form of light. So here, option C will be the correct answer. Fiber optic are the cables which carry data signals in the form of light. Then we'll go to C, question number 135. In a fiber optic cable, the signal is propagated along the inner core by. Okay, now along the inner core, if you want to propagate the travel, the line, the light to be going from one point to another, then that light which is traveling, that light ray which is traveling within the core follows a principle of total internal reflection. So it is the answer reflection. So B will be the answer here, reflection. Okay, then we'll go to the next question. Question number 136. Which transmission media has the highest transmission speed in a network? Now, if you see coaxial cable, twisted pair, optical fiber, and electric cable, it is obviously light travels faster than electricity. That means optical fiber should be the answer here, which will be having the highest transmission speed. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 137. Bits can be sent over guided and unguided media as analog signal by what? Digital modulation, amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, or phase modulation. Okay. Bits can be sent over a guided and unguided media as analog signal by digital modulation. Okay. Now, in digital modulation, you can have ASK, PSK, FSK, where the bits are taken, 10, 10, 10, whatever binary data you have, the bits are taken and the bits are going to modulate a high frequency carrier. And based on that, whether it is going to change the amplitude or frequency or phase, you're going to get what is amplitude shift keying, what is frequency shift keying, or what is phase shift keying. That means it is going to follow digital modulation. So bits can be sent over a guided and unguided media as analog signals by digital modulation. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 138. Loss in signal power as light travels down the fiber is called. Now always loss is called as attenuation. Loss is called as attenuation. So here obviously the answer should be answer A, attenuation. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 139. Which of the following performs modulation and demodulation? Okay. The options are fiber optic. Fiber optic is a cable. It will not perform modulation, demodulation. Option B is switch. Switch also will not perform. It is just on off. C is modulator. So it is doing only modulation. D is modem. Modem. M-O-D-E-M. In which M-O means modulator and D-E-M means demodulator. So modem is a unit which performs modulation and demodulation. Okay. Then we'll go to the next question. Question number 140. Which of the following is not a transmission medium? Okay. Which of the following is not a transmission medium? So if you see the options, option A is telephone lines. Telephone lines is a guided transmission media. Option B is coaxial cables. Coaxial cable is a guided media. Modem is a unit which will do modulatory demodulatory. It is not a transmission media. Microwave systems can be a transmission media for wireless. That means here the option which is not a transmission media is option C, that is modem. Okay. So here we finish the questions on optical fiber, coaxial cable, twisted pair cables, and transmission media. Okay. So here I end my digital communication DCT and I have covered a few questions. Now, based on such type of questions only, such type of concepts only, any other objective also can be asked in exams. So again, I say that your basics, your fundamentals should be clear about any subject, so that if anything is asked in exams, you can always have a logic for it and you can get the answer. Okay. So thank you, students. So here we finish our digital communication DCET questions. Okay.